follow everybody but the right person. Amen. But I want you to take notice to how Nehemiah did. Amen. Nehemiah, amen, he took a different approach. And he went in prayer. Do I have a witness here? Amen. My Bible says in Matthew 6:33, he says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all of these things shall be added unto you. Can I get a witness? One thing about Nehemiah is that he knew God. Can I get a witness? I'm sure that there were quite a few times that he had prayed to God before taking on a task. Amen. There were plenty other times that he had prayed short prayers. Amen. Because he was the king's cupbearer. And what that means is that if anybody wanted to try to poison the king, Nehemiah would get it first. So I'm quite sure Nehemiah had to know God. Can I get a witness? How many know that there are so many right now that wanna harm governors and other people? They try anything they can. Amen. But they had to come through Nehemiah when it came to the king. Do I have a witness here?
Well.
Amen. And as we continue to study, amen, we go on to the second chapter. Let's give us a brief synopsis on the second chapter. Amen. The second chapter, we were entitled, amen, the leader and his superiors. In chapter one, we saw the problem. Amen. The problem was, amen, that the walls of Jerusalem was in ruins. The wall was torn down. But in this particular chapter, the second chapter, amen, we see the solution to the problem. What is the solution to the problem? Amen. Nehemiah had prayed to God and asked him for the solution. The second chapter shows us how we should deal with our superiors. After Nehemiah had prayed to God for direction, God showed him how to deal with King Artaxerxes. As he approached the king, he looked as if he was sad. Amen. The king asked him, say, what's the matter? You've never been in this. You've never come to me, amen, before me looking this way. Amen. You've never had a sad face. These years that you served me as the chief cupbearer, you've never had a sad face. You never looked like that. So tell me what the matter is. You see, God will show you exactly what to do when you go right. Can I get a witness? Amen. As he approached the king, he was sad. The king asked him what the matter was. And the way that he said it was so, see, God will give you exactly what to say and how to say it. Can I get a witness?
Well.
Amen. What he did was he went to the king. He said, king, he said, long live the king forever. Can I get a witness? Now, if you want to go to somebody with authority, amen, there is a particular way that you go to the person with authority. Amen. You don't go with your chest stuck out. Amen. And some folks go with their lips poked out. Amen. But the way that, amen, Nehemiah went to the king was that he went with a sad face. Amen. And how he got the king's attention was, he said, long live the king. Lord have mercy. In other words, he stroked the king's ego. Some of us wonder why our supervisor or our manager won't give us a day off. Amen. Because we go to him. I know you ain't going to do it, but I need tomorrow. That's the wrong way. Amen. But when you go to him and say, you know, brother supervisor, that tie look real good. Amen. And he might give you the whole week off. Can I get a witness? Amen. But Nehemiah went in a particular way. Uh-huh. Amen. He went with him, went to him with the right approach. Uh-huh. Amen. And the scripture that reminds me of this particular chapter says, Jesus said to him in Mark 9:23, uh-huh. if thou can believe uh-huh. all things uh-huh. are possible to him that believes.
Yes.
Can I
yes.
get a witness?
Yes.
All you got to do is believe.
Yes.
And all things are possible.
Yes. Yes.
Not only did he have permission,
mm-hmm.
amen, but when he asked the king the way that he asked him,
yeah. right,
the king gave him everything that he needed all right. to complete the job.
Yes.
My mama used to say something. My mama say, son, you can draw more people with sweetness
uh-huh.
yeah. than you can with bitterness.
Yeah. Yeah.
How many people love honey?
Yeah.
Honey attracts flies.
Yeah.
Honey attracts ants.
Yeah.
Honey attracts gnats.
Yeah.
Honey attracts bees.
Yeah.
Honey attracts bears.
Yeah.
Honey attracts people.
Yeah.
But what does a lemon attract?
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen. I'm going to give it to you like God gave it to me. Thirdly, we go to the third chapter.
Mm-hmm.
And we label this chapter as taking command.
Mm-hmm.
Here lies the taking of command of the problem.
Mm-hmm.
The church, third chapter deals with Nehemiah
mm-hmm.
after he arrives in Jerusalem
mm-hmm.
making plans to oversee the building of the wall.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The number one thing that we want to bring out about this chapter
mm-hmm.
is the fact that Nehemiah, with the help of God, planned out the whole wall
mm-hmm.
to be rebuilt.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Not only did he say we're gonna just rebuild the wall,
mm-hmm.
amen, but the way that he did it was so smart.
Mm-hmm.
It was a very smart decision.
Mm-hmm.
Not the only did he cut out the travel time
mm-hmm.
to get to the wall.
Mm-hmm.
But what he did was, every place where the wall was,
mm-hmm.
those that lived in that vicinity,
mm-hmm.
he asked them to rebuild the wall
yeah.
in their vicinity.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It cut out travel time mm-hmm. to the job.
All right.
Amen. Some of us travel for hours or sometimes minutes to get to the job.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Amen. But these people, when they wanted to start working on the wall,
yeah.
amen, all they had to do was walk out of their door.
Yeah.
Right. Can I get a witness?
Yeah. Right.
Not only, amen, was it close to the job.
Uh-huh.
Amen. But each man's house was in the vicinity.
Uh-huh.
So when they were preparing the wall,
uh-huh.
don't you think you would make sure that your wall by your house
yeah.
was really
all
strong?
Right. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Can I get a witness?
Uh-huh.
This is how Nehemiah did.
Uh-huh.
Everyone that was in the vicinity of their own household
uh-huh.
was required to build the wall.
Uh-huh.
And if the wall was by your house,
uh-huh.
won't you make it strong?
Uh-huh.
So when the enemy comes, he won't attack your house.
Uh-huh.
Can I get a witness?
Well.
And the scripture that comes to mind is Romans 8:31.
Uh-huh.
What shall we say to these things?
Uh-huh.
If God be for us,
all right.
who can be against
us?
Uh-huh. Can I get a witness?
Well,
let us move on to the chapter where I want to get to.
Uh-huh.
Amen. The fourth chapter.
Uh-huh.
Amen. We have, let me give it to you like you gave it to me.
All right.
We have taken command.
Uh-huh.
Well, first of all, let me go to the first chapter.
Uh-huh.
The first chapter, we see the problem.
Right. Uh-huh. Yeah.
The second chapter, we see the solution to the problem.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Thirdly, we see the taking of command.
Uh-huh.
Now, fourth chapter, we want to deal with the opposition.
Uh-huh. All right.
Everyone in here knows about opposition.
Uh-huh.
What is opposition?
Well,
the action of opposing or resisting or combating.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.